Hey everyone, Dion here, and today we're going to be taking a look at the Retroflag GPI case and some of the things I've learned since its release in mid-2019. The Retroflag GPI case is a Raspberry Pi Zero powered portable gaming device that looks a lot like the original Nintendo Game Boy, it's just slightly smaller. And it's got a ton of upgrades. You'll be happy to know that this thing eats batteries just like the original Game Boy did, but you get a whole lot more bang for your buck. And we'll talk a little bit more about that in just a minute. Let's talk a little bit about the GPI features first. Compared to the Game Boy, it's got an upgraded button setup similar to the button setup you find on the Super Nintendo controller. We've got the A, B, X, and Y buttons on the front in the standard Nintendo configuration. You'll notice on the back we have the L and R buttons. They're slightly hidden, with some raised bumps to help you find them. And you'll notice that we've got a standard D-pad and a select and start button. It has a full color 2.8 inch IPS screen that runs at a 320 by 240 pixel resolution. And it looks pretty decent. As you can see, I've got a screen protector on mine to keep it nice and safe. And I've got a link for that in the description if you're interested. It's got a mono speaker, headphone jack, power jack and cable, volume adjuster, and a screen brightness adjuster. And here on the back is where it eats batteries. It's got a place for three AA batteries. You'll notice there's also a small on-off switch inside the battery bay. This is to turn on a cool, safe shutdown feature. The reason this feature is important is because the GPI case runs a complete operating system in the background. It's just like your personal computer. You want to make sure it shuts down safely when you flip the off switch, or you could end up with corruption issues, which will cause your device to stop working properly. Speaking of off switches, here's the on-off switch for the case, as well as the cool removable mock cartridge, which has a slot in it for the micro SD card you're going to need. These are all the main features of the case itself. The GPI case uses a Raspberry Pi Zero, or Zero W, as its computing power. When you have your Raspberry Pi, you'll put it inside the mock cartridge that slides into the back of the case. This is a pretty neat touch in my opinion. Retroflag definitely wanted to give it some cool factor. One very important note here is that you cannot use this case unless you have a Raspberry Pi Zero or Zero W to put inside of it. Let's talk about the Raspberry Pi Zero for a minute. It is one cool mini computer. It's about the size of a couple of sticks of gum. It's got a 1 GHz ARM processor and 512 MB of RAM. There's also an upgraded version of the Raspberry Pi Zero that has Bluetooth and Wi-Fi called the Raspberry Pi Zero W. I can tell you right now that getting the Raspberry Pi Zero W is well worth a few extra bucks. The wireless is going to make your life easier when you try to put games on the device or do any kind of updates. The amount of storage you want to put on the device is completely up to you. Raspberry Pis use microSD cards for storage, so you can put any size you want in it. For most people, I'd recommend a 16 GB card. You'd probably want to get a bigger card if you plan on putting more modern games on the device, like games from say the PlayStation, the Nintendo 64, GameCube, and so on. Those games take up quite a bit more space than retro classics such as Nintendo, Super Nintendo, and original Game Boy games. The Pi Zero is definitely not a powerhouse of a computer, and it has a hard time running games from newer systems like the PS1 and GameCube. Some of you may be happy to know that there's an entire community of people out there trying to eke out every ounce of ability out of the Raspberry Pi to run as many games as possible on this thing. You are more than welcome to join them. Personally, I'm not super interested in playing games from newer systems on the device. The device itself doesn't have controls to make playing some of the newer games comfortable, so you'll have to pair a Bluetooth controller or something similar to be able to play more modern games. That's totally up to you. Now, let's talk about the software. The Raspberry Pi runs a special flavor of Linux called Raspbian. Most people that get a GPI case are going to use RetroPi to run their games. RetroPi and Emulation Station are an easily configurable and great looking front end built on Raspbian to make it easy to play games. It's pretty straightforward and there's a lot of documentation online to help you get started. The RetroPi website, wiki, and forum are really great resources. I'll put a link to their site in the description. RetroPi isn't the only front end you can use for playing retro games on a device like the GPI case, but personally I like it. It's very clean, simple, and I love the ability to customize it by building your own themes. When it comes time to add games to your RetroPie, you'll definitely want to check out their documentation. If you aren't already familiar with emulators and ROMs, you'll definitely want to take a minute to read their documentation to kind of get a feel for how these things work. Basically, emulators are a piece of software that emulate a game system, like the original Game Boy, for example. And a ROM is the game file itself, basically a copy of the game cartridge or disc. RetroPie comes pre-configured with the emulators you're going to need, but the ROMs you're going to have to find yourself. You can start with a clean image of RetroPie for your GPie case by downloading one from the RetroPie website, or you can get one of the pre-built images that are pre-configured that can help you get up and running faster. I would definitely recommend getting one of the pre-built images. There are some special patches from RetroFlag that you'll have to install to tell the GPie case to send video to its small screen. There's also another patch you'll have to install to tell it to take advantage of the safe shutdown option. There is documentation for these patches on the RetroFlag website, but they can be a little tricky to install if you're not familiar with things like GitHub and command line utilities. I highly recommend checking out the GPie case community image. It's the one I started with, and I found it worked pretty well. It's a pretty minimal image, and it comes pre-installed with a couple of games, so you can get your feet wet. There's a link to this group in the description, and I'll also put a link to their Discord and Facebook group, all of which are very helpful. I'll also put a couple of links in the description that'll tell you some of the tweaks and patches installed in the image that help make it work great for the GPie case. You can pick up the RetroFlag GPie case on Amazon for about $70. If you like retro gaming, you definitely need to check this out. I posted a link for it down in the description. I mentioned in the beginning of the video that we'd be talking about batteries. It does eat batteries, but not more than I'd expect. You're gonna get roughly 4 hours of gameplay off of 3 AA batteries. I'd recommend getting some rechargeable AA batteries to use in your device. And consensus says that the IKEA LATA batteries are the ones that work the best. These batteries are gonna end up holding a charger longer than any other batteries on the market. They also keep their ability to be recharged more times than any other battery on the market. So you're gonna get a lot of use out of them. So if you're getting yourself a GPie case, definitely check out the LATA batteries. If you plan on using it on the go, they're gonna be indispensable. I'll put a link to the batteries in the description. Another little add-on for the GPie case that I'd recommend getting is a hard case to carry it in. You wanna keep this thing safe. I found a small external hard drive case on Amazon that works great for the GPie. It costs about $10 and it's a semi-hard zipper case. On one side, there's a band that holds the GPie in place, and on the other side is a mesh net that'll hold your charging cable and some extra batteries if you need them. There's also a link for this down in the description. I'll also put a link to the glass screen protectors I found. I got a 2-pack for under $10. They fit the screen perfectly. Anyway, that's the RetroFlag GPie case. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, I'd appreciate it if you hit the like button below. And also, if you want to see more content from me like this, make sure to subscribe to my channel. I hope to see you again soon.